Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And tonight we are continuing with my series on samples that I bought 2 weeks ago. And tonight we are looking at a cask strength, and this is the Aaron Sherry cask, the Bodega. Bottled at an eye-watering 55.8% ABV. It's matured 100% in ex-sherry casks. Uncolored, non-chill filtered, so we're ticking all the boxes. And this is the new bottling. Well, I'm not so sure how new it is. I did try the previous, the older bottle version, did like it, so I'm quite curious to see what the new bottling will taste like or if there's any difference. So this is a non-age statement whiskey. I will try to find some information on it to see if I can find out how old the whiskies are in it, but if I do find something, I will put something in the link or the description or just somewhere above for your information. So I'm gonna give it a pour. It is bottled at 55.8% ABV, so gonna be quite strong. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a nosing, gonna give it a little bit of a taste. I don't like drinking it at this high ABV. So always add a little bit of water, but I'm going to give it a try without the water first and give my opinion, and then I'm going to add some water. So color wise it's a nice deep amber color, so it looks fantastic uncolored. So they did get a lot of color in it. It is really, really nice. But before I get that, it's not the usual cask that they are using. They use a hogshead, so smaller cask. Normally it will be in a puncheon, which is much bigger, 500-600 liters. So this is much smaller, so of course it will pick up a lot more color quite fast. So on the nose, cheers. So the nose is absolutely fantastic. And I was thinking at 55.8%, you're gonna get a lot of alcohol notes. Even if you really stick your nose into it, you get a little bit of an alcohol burn. But if you just keep it close enough to get the aromas, it is fantastic. It's a light sweetness. You get the sherry, but it's not a what I would call a sherry bomb. If you go into the Edradour 10, that for me is a sherry bomb, and you do get that hit of sherry, big dark sherry notes. This for me is a little bit different. So the sherry is there, but it, for me, it's quite light on the nose. It's not a strong, dark sherry note. Fruity, lots of fruity notes. A little bit of a chocolate note. Not a dark chocolate, but a light, maybe 50% cocoa chocolate type of notes. And when I get fresh cherries. Wow, that is really fantastic on the nose. Not what I expected, actually. A little bit of a caramel note. Some vanilla definitely coming out. And a little bit of a buttery note. Like just a hint of butter coming out for me. So, the alcohol, yeah, very light on it. really nice on the nose. So I'm going to give it a little bit of a taste, not much, to see what it what's the taste like without water. So cheers. So immediately I get the alcohol. It feels hot. It feels like it just disappears in your mouth. And what you are left with is sweet, oily, sticky toffee, a little bit of a chocolate note, and no oak. Absolutely no oak. Just this hot sweetness. This is really nice. I'm just going to give it a little extra try. So the oiliness is there. It just coats your whole mouth. With it is exactly like eating a toffee. And it creates a little bit of a oiliness and it just coats your mouth and everything is just sweet. Wow, that is really nice. But of course, I think I will be able to drink this without water. But I think if I add a little bit of water, it's going to make a big difference as well. And if you buy a bottle, it costs around 47 euros on my online store. And at that high proof, and you add some water, a 70 centiliter bottle can go quite a long way. Really nice. A little bit of a dusty note also coming out. So yeah, I'm gonna add a little bit of water just to don't kill the palate. So on that one, I'm not gonna add too much. Maybe I've got a teaspoon of water. If I add maybe a little bit more, so 1.5 teaspoons of water. So I don't want to overkill it in the beginning. If I feel that I need to add more water a little bit later on, I can do it, but of course you can't take the water out. So I'm just going to start off with this one with a teaspoon, 1.5 teaspoons of water. So the first thing that I get, if I add a little bit of water, I get a lot more fruity flavors coming out and a little bit more caramel coming out. Much more sweeter on the nose, a little bit perfumey actually coming out, light perfume, vanilla definitely more elevated, and a little bit of that dusty note, it just gets elevated a little bit. It's so pleasant. And then the chocolate, it also gets a little bit of an elevation, nice light chocolate, and I get the fruity flavors coming out. It's fantastic. So on the taste of water, cheers. Wow, this is nice. This is absolutely fantastic. I need to try some more. So it's a little bit more sweeter. And the reason that I went for the second sip is I'm looking for something. And what am I looking for? I'm looking for the oak. Because normally on the first taste, I don't get so much oak. Third, fourth sip, I get the oak coming in. Let me just try again. No oak. Wow, I've been looking for this one for for the last 2 years, I think. I don't love the oak. This is just absolutely awesome. So less oily, not so much covering the mouth. That hotness of the alcohol is now actually perfect. A toffee note. Chocolate notes coming out. I can feel the sweetness of a chocolate. I do get the sherry But a light sherry, not an overly sweet type of sherry. Dates, I get a little bit of a fig. It's light. Still no oak, really, really nice. Fruity, oh, that is really nice. It's a little bit of a raisins coming out as well. And then a hint of a chocolate coming out. The oak. But it is, if a scale from 1 to 10, I think it is about half when we look at the oak in it. So, my thoughts. It is fantastic. I've been looking for this one. I think I found it. This is definitely going to be on my list for the best whiskey for 2021. And also probably going to be on my list for my predictions for 2022. Really fantastic. So if I have to give it a score, I'm going to give it an 89 out of 100. For me, on my taste profile, my palate, my nose, this is really good. And it's ticking the boxes, that high ABV, that you can add your water for your preferences. It's unfiltered. It is no color added. Everything that you really need in a whiskey is in this glass. Fantastic nose, fantastic taste. Big fan of it. And I am going to buy myself a big boy bottle as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe, or don't like and subscribe, but do subscribe. Also, for the people that stayed until the end, thank you very much. I have one more note. I have a Patreon account, which I created for the sole purpose of getting money for kids in South Africa. We have a charity that supports 85 children and tough times in South Africa now with the pandemic. And I would appreciate it if you want to give him some money. Just follow the link in the description and let's help them out as well. So, see you next time. Cheers.